We're back with another Next.js release, 13.2, including some major improvements to the app router or app directory as we push forward towards stability. Let's take a look. In Next.js 13.2, we have built-in SEO support through a new metadata API, making it easier than ever to customize meta in link tags to optimize your site for sharing on the web. This replaces the previously beta API head.js, which was temporarily used to do metadata inside of the new app router. So let's take a look at these new changes. On my left in my editor, I have my root layout inside of my application. Now, as a quick refresher, the app directory or app router has support for nested layouts, and our root layout is at the top of our tree. So at the top of our tree, at the entry point into our application, we're rendering a layout, including our HTML document, and we're able to set some metadata on our document, including the title and the description. Now, if we look over in the right in our browser, we see that in the head of our HTML document, we see not only the two default meta tags added for the viewport as well as the character set, we see the title and the description. Now, you might be wondering, okay, this works for global metadata on my application, but what about when I want to customize it on a per route basis? So to demonstrate this, let's look at this page, /products, inside of app/products/page.tsx, where this is rendering the product page. And on this page, we've overridden the metadata to define a different title. Now on the right, if I go in our browser and I navigate to /products, you'll see that the head element here is updated to override and take the new title value for products while keeping the previously defined metadata at the root of our layout. So you can override this as you see fit. But what about if we have dynamic metadata? Don't worry, the new metadata API with the app router has you taken care of. Let's look at a little bit more of a complete example. So on the left in my editor, we have /products folder/ID, which is a dynamic route segment taking in some value. And then we have a page.tsx for this route. Now, inside of this file, we have a generate metadata function. This is the special sauce that allows you to handle generating dynamic metadata for a page based on some external API call, some database call, etc. So in this file, on line 22 here, we're grabbing the product data for this route based on the dynamic parameter of ID. Now, that ID is, again, defined by that dynamic route segment defined in the file. And then we're returning the title just like we did when it was static, but in this instance, we're pulling that value back returned from the API. Now, a really neat thing about the app router in Next.js is that the same data fetching code, the same promise that we use to fetch our product for generate metadata, we can also use inside of our actual product page, our server component, where we're rendering our product. And because there's an automatic deduplication and automatic fetch caching, that same request will only happen once. So we're able to easily reuse that function's result across both generating the metadata as well as actually rendering out that page. So over in the right in the browser, notice that we see the text of the product title as well as we see the metadata updated with the title of the product name. And if I were to change from products/1 to 2, this is a dynamic route, so it reads that value of 2 and changes the API call based on that data. One last bonus point that's really nice in the app router is that you'll notice that I'm able to use getProduct inside of my server component, and it's fully typed end to end. So if you notice on product, I see the value of this interface product that we've defined. I can do .title and access what properties are here. So if I type something wrong, for example, I'll get those helpful lines in my editor where TypeScript is telling me, hey, by the way, you used a value that does not exist. All right, next up in 13.2, let's talk about route handlers. Route handlers allow you to create custom request handlers that take in some web request and return some web response. So this is built on web standard APIs, and this API is an evolution of the API route inside of the pages directory. So this is specifically for the app router in Next.js 13.2, and it allows you to seamlessly transition between the different runtimes in Next.js, both the Node.js runtime as well as the Edge runtime, and learn these web APIs once and use them everywhere, inside of route handlers, inside of your rendering code, inside of middleware, and in other frameworks. Now, you'll notice the convention here inside of this route.ts file that I've defined inside of my file system. That's what marks this route as a route handler. So slash items. Again, this doesn't have to be named API. This is a new concept that is inspired by API routes. So in my browser on the right, I'm at slash items, and this is a GET request. And you see it's returning the text items. So I have a new function here that is returning a response for the GET request. But the nice thing about route handlers is that I can define any of the HTTP verbs, whether it's a put, a post, a GET, a delete, etc. And I can use those inside of the same file. So no more if statements for having to check whether it's a GET or a post or a put. And because this is built on the same primitives as the rest of the app router, I can also use helpful functions like headers or cookies to easily access these values and even extract this logic out into shared functions across my rendering code as well as my route handler. Next.js 13.2 also includes something that I've wanted for a long time, truly an amazing innovation inside of the framework, and that is statically typed links. So if you're using TypeScript and you're using the app router, wouldn't it be amazing if the framework could tell you that you had a typo when you're trying to link to another page? So let's take a look at what I mean. On this product page, so products slash page.tsx or slash products inside of my browser, I have a link to the homepage. And the homepage href here is slash to go back to the index route. And everything works fine here. If I click on home in the browser, I go back to the homepage. But let's say I made a mistake and I accidentally typed this. Now, this slash G route does not exist. And now Next.js with statically typed links and using the TypeScript plugin is able to automatically understand all of the routes in your application and give you those helpful red squiggly lines wherever you're using TypeScript so that you can get this in editor feedback before you ship the prod and then notice your link isn't working. So this is a massive developer experience win that will hopefully help you create more safe applications when navigating between pages. Now, let's say I didn't have a typo on the string for my href, but I had a typo somewhere else in my code that caused my code to throw an error. Now, in 13.2, we've really improved the error overlay to give you helpful information when you're debugging. So in my browser, you'll notice first off, in the top right, it tells me that Next.js is up to date. So this version staleness indicator can help you understand, is it because I'm on an older version where maybe this fix has been patched, or am I on the latest version and maybe it's an issue in my code? Second, we've now broken out specific stack traces for both Next.js and React, so it's easier to understand, is this a Next.js code error or is it maybe an upstream error with React? That can greatly help with your debugging, and we're really excited to roll out this improved error overlay in 13.2. Now, that's not all for new features and improvements in Next.js 13.2. There's also MDX support for server components, which you can use in Next.js's own plugin or in community packages. There's a new Rust-based MDX parser that will help speed up all of your builds that are using MDX with Next.js. And there's also improvements to TurboPack, which is in alpha, including much better support inside of Next.js as we're furthering along the path towards beta and support and compat with some Webpack loaders. So you might want to check out TurboPack if you haven't. Let us know your feedback on the app router as we push forward towards stability and stay tuned for the next one.